about Beatrice. Even so, Hero and Margaret have had this place apart from Beatrice, so now the two bears will not bite one another when they meet.
My lord and brother, God save you.
Yes, sir.
If you'll please your serge, I would speak with you.
In private?
If it please you, yet Count Claudio may hear, for what I would speak of concerns him.
What's the matter?
Means your lordship to be married tomorrow.
You know he does.
I know not that when he knows what I know.
Well, if there be any impediment, I pray you discover it.
You may think that I love you not. Let that appear hereafter and aim better at me by that.
What's the matter?
I came hither to tell you, and circumstances shortened, for she has been too long in talking of. The lady is disloyal.
Who, Hero? Even she, Leonardo's hero, your hero, every man's hero.
Disloyal.
The word is too good to paint out her wickedness. I could say she were worse. Think you of a worse title, and I will fit her to it. Wonder not till further warrant. Go but with me tonight, and you shall see her chamber window entered, even the night before her wedding day. If you love her then, tomorrow wed her, but it would better fit your honor to change your mind.
Can this be so? I will not think it.
If you dare not trust that you see, confess not that you know. If you will follow me, I will show you enough. But when you have seen more and heard more, proceed accordingly.
Well, if I should see anything tonight why I should not marry her tomorrow in the congregation where I should wed, then there will I shame her.
And as I wooed for thee to obtain her, I will join thee to disgrace her.
I will disparage her no farther till you are my witnesses. Bear it coldly but till midnight, and let the issue show itself.
A day toward the turn, a mischief strangely thwarting.
Oh, plague right well prevented! So will you say when you have seen the sequel.
Salvation, body and soul.
Nay, that would be a punishment too great. If they have any allegiance in them, they're chosen for the Jedi.
Well then, give them their charge, Master Jedi.
First, who think you're the most desertless man to be constable?
Me, or George Seagull, sir, for we can write and read.
Come hither, neighbor.
Seagull, sir!
God has blessed you with a good name, and to be a well-favored man is a gift of fortune. But to write and read comes by nature.
Both, which, Master Constable...
You have. I knew it would be your answer. The force is strong with this one. And as for your writing and reading, let that appear when there is no need of the light side of the force. You are thought here to be the most fit and senseless man to be constable. Therefore, bear you the lantern. This is your charm. You ought to comprehend all vagrom men. You ought to bid any man stand in the prince's name.
How will that stand?
Why then? Take no note of him. But let him go. And presently call the rest of the watch together and thank God you are rid of a knave.
If he will not stand when he is bidden, then it is obvious that he is none of the prince's subjects.
True, and they are to meddle with none but the prince's subjects.
Grandfather, Jar Jar!
Ewok
Jawar!
But there's no noise in the halls. For the Jedi to babble and to talk is tolerable and not to be endured.
We will rather sleep than talk. We know it belongs to a Jedi.
Why, you speak like most ancient quiet Padawan. If I do not see how sleeping should have been, take care your saber is stolen.
Oh, yeah. So, baby, you want to get some?
Oh, you guys are just a bunch of freaking retards.
You want to call at all the restrooms and bid those that are smoking? Get them to class.
How can we not?
Why, then, let them alone till they are done? If they make you not, then the better answer is say they are not the men you took them for.
Yes, my master.
Hey, yo, when they ain't looking, all this crap's free!
You need a thief in the halls? You may suspect him by your virtue to be no true man! And for such kind of men, the less you meddle or make with them, why, the more is for your honesty.
If we know him to be a thief, shall we not lay hands on him?
Truly, by your office, you may. But I think they that touch pitch will be defiled. The most peaceable way for you, if you do take a thief, is to let him show him what he is and steal out of your company.
You've always been called, merciful, yes, merciful.
Truly, I would not hang a dog by my will, much less a man with any honesty in him.
Get back here, you stupid freshman! Oh, I'll make it to
come
you!
On. Come on!
Oh, here comes the shame! Oh, not yet! Oh!
Oh, dude, come on, let's go! Come on,
come on, let's go!
Oh, yeah.
Come on!
Hear a freshman cry in the halls.
What's the goat for?
Meh! Go to the nurse and understand.
There is no god!
How she be asleep and will not hear us call?
Why, then let the child wake her with its cry. For the ewe that does not answer its lamb when it bays will not answer the calf when he bleats.
It's very true.
Give me that egg beater!
This is the end of your charge. You are to present the prince's own person. If you meet the prince in the night, you may stay.
Nay, by the force, I think they cannot.
5-1 with any man that knows the statutes they may. Marry not without the prince be willing. For the Jedi should offend no man, and it is an offense to stay a man against his will.
By the force, I think it be so.
Ha ha ha! Well, masters, good night. If there be any matter of weight chances, call me up. Keep your fellow's counsel and your own. Come, apprentice.
While we hear our charge, let us go sit here upon the band bench till 2, and then all is bed.
One word more, honest neighbors. I bid you watch about Signor Leonardo's office. For the wedding being there tomorrow, there is a great coil tonight. Adieu, be vigilant, I beseech you.
Yeah, sit on this bench and let me tell you what's up, man.
Oh yeah, grape soda like a villain.
Some treason!
Yo, know that tonight I've earned of Dawn $1,000.
Bling, bling! How can villainy be so dear, yo?
Now she'd rather ask how villainy should be so rich. But when rich villains gotta eat the poor ones make what price they will.
Jiggle, what?
I know it's the fashion of a doublet, or a hat, or a cloak. It's nothing to a man.
Word, it is the apparel, yo.
I mean, the fashion.
Straight up, man, the fashion is the fashion.
Tush, man, I may as well say the fool's the fool. But see us out now what a deformed thief this fashion really is.
That's quite a
working
you got.
Son of you, somebody!
No, it was a van on the house, yo.
Well, see us out now, I say, what a deformed thief this fashion really is. Now get it, turns about all the hot bloods between 14 and 5 and 30. Sometimes fashion them like Pharaoh's soldiers in that reeky painting.
Sometimes, like God bails priest in the old church window. And sometimes, like that shaven Hercules and that smirch worm-eating tapestry where his codpiece seems as messy as his clothes.
Oh, yeah. But art not thou thyself ditty with the telling of this tale? To have shifted out of the telling and the telling me of the fashion, yo.
Not so, neither. But know that tonight I have wooed Margaret, the lady heroes gentlewoman, by the name of Hero. She leans me out of her mistress's chamber window and bids me a thousand times good night, oh, I tell this tale vilely.
Word.
But I should first tell thee how the Franks and Claudio and my mistress, planted and placed and possessed by my mistress Dawn, saw far off in the orchard this amiable encounter.
And thought that Margaret was Hero, yo.
Two of them did, the Prince and Claudio. But the devil, my mistress, knew she was Margaret. And partly by her oaths, which first possessed him. And partly by the dark night, which did deceive him. But chiefly by my villainy, which did confirm any slander Don had made. Away went Claudio enraged. He swore he would meet her, as he was appointed, next morning at the temple. And there, before the whole congregation, shame her with what he saw overnight. Send that slut home again without a husband.
Word!
Well, we have here recovered the most dangerous piece of country ever known in the Commonwealth.
Crack us, please!
We obey you to go with us.
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna go with you. I'm gonna get some, baby.
Bust it out, bust it up. It's a fun loving criminals.
Not so good, and I warrant your cousin will say so.
My cousin's a fool, and thou art another. I'll wear none but this.
I like the new tire with an excellent link. The hair were thought browner. Your gown's most refreshing fate. I saw the Duchess of Milan's gown that they praised, so.
Oh, that exceeds, they say.
By my choice, but a nightgown I respect yours. Cloth of gold and cuts, lace with silver, set with pearls, down sleeves, side sleeves, and skirts. Brown underborn with a bluish tinsel. But for a fine, quaint, graceful, and excellent fashion, yours is with a ten of it.
God give me joy to wear it, for my heart is exceeding heavy.
To be heavier soon by the weight of a man.
Good morrow, Cass.
Good morrow, sweet hero.
Why, how now do you speak in the sick tune?
I'm out of all other tune, methinks.
Crops into light of love. That goes without burden. Do you sing it?
And I'll dance it.
You lie to love with your heels. Then if your husband have stables enough, you shall see he lack no barns.
Oh, illegitimate construction. I scorn that with my heels.
'Tis almost 5 o'clock, cousin. 'Tis time you were ready. By my troth, I am exceeding ill.
For a hawk, a horse, or a husband.
For the letter that begins them all, H.
Well, and you be not turned Turk. There's no more sailing by the star.
What means the fool, I wonder?
Nothing I. But God send everyone their heart's desire.
The Count sent me these gloves. They're an excellent perfume.
I'm stuffed, cousin. I cannot smell.
A maid and stuffed. There's goodly catching of cold.
Oh, God help me. How long have you professed apprehension?
Ever since you left it. Doth not my wits become me rarely?
It is not seen enough. You should wear it in your cap.
Oh, I know. Give some of this distilled Carduus Benedictus. And lay it to your heart. It is the only thing for a qualm.
There thou prickest her with a thistle.
Benedictus. Why Benedictus? Have you some meaning in this Benedictus?
Meaning? No. I have no meaning.
What pace is this that my tongue keeps?
Not a false gallop.
Church.
Help me to dress, good cud.
Good mess.
You beg.
With me, honest neighbors?
Marry, sir, we would have some confidence with you that discerns you near.
Well, be brief. This is a busy time with me, as you can see.
Marry, that it is, sir.
Yes, indeed, yes, sir.
Well, what would you with me then, honest neighbors?
Goodman Burgess, sir, speaks a little off the matter. His wit are not as blunt as God help I would desire they were. But in truth, are as honest as the skin between his brows.
Oh, yes, I thank God that I am as honest as any man, as an old man. No honester than I.
Comparisons are odorous, apprentice.
Neighbors, you're getting rather tedious.
It pleases your worship to say so. But we are the poor duke's officers. For mine own part, if I were as tedious as a king, I would find it in my heart to bestow it all upon your worship.
Oh, all thy tediousness on me, huh?
Yea, and 12,000 pounds more than 'tis. For I hear as good an exclamation of you as of any man in the city. And though I be but a poor man, I am glad to hear it.
So am I.
Well, I would fain know what you gentlemen have to say, then.
Marry, sir, our watch this night has taken as couple of as errant knaves as any in Messina High.
You're kidding. You mean you two didn't screw up? You actually did something right. That's incredible. Congratulations,
Fergus.
Fergus, take their examination upon yourselves. I am very busy. Thank you.
Go! Get you to Sarah Sexton. Bid her bring in Pinkle to detention. We are to examination these men.
Oh, yes, and we must do so wisely.
We will spare no wit, I warrant you.
Sister, you come to marry them.
Lady, you come hither to be married to this count.
I do.
If either of you know any inward impediment why you should not be conjoined, I charge you on your souls to utter it.
Know you any hero?
None, my lord.
Know you any count?
Oh, I dare make his answer none.
Oh, what men dare do, what men may do, what men daily do, not knowing what they do.
How now? Interjections? Why then some be of laughing as I eat?
That's not right.
Father, by your leave, will you with free and unconstrained soul give me this maid your daughter?
Oh, as freely, son, as God did give her me.
What have I to give you back, whose worth may counterpoise this rich and precious gift?
Nothing, unless you render her again.
Sweet prince, you learn me noble thankfulness. Leonardo, take her back again. Give not this rotten orange to your friend. She is but the sign and semblance of her honor. Oh, behold how like a maid she blushes here. Oh, what authority and show of truth can cunning sin cover itself withal? Comes not that blood as modest evidence to witness simple virtue? Would you not swear, all you that see her, that she were a maid by these exterior shows? But she is none. She knows the heat
of a luxurious bed. Her blush is guiltiness, not modesty.
What means you by this, my lord?
Not to be married. Not to knit my soul to an approved wanton.
Dear my lord, if you have, in the practice of your own youth, vanquished her resistance and made the feat of her virginity.
Oh, I know what you would say. If I have known her, then she did embrace me as a husband, and so extenuate beforehand sin. No, Leonato! I never tempted her with word too large, but as a brother to his sister, showed bashful sincerity and comely love.
And seemed I ever otherwise to you?
Oh, out on thee, seeming! I will write against it. You seem to me as Diane in her orb, as chaste as the bud ere it be blown. But you are more intemperate in your blood than Venus, or those pampered animals that rage in savage sensuality.
Is my lord well that he doth speak so wide?
Sweet prince, why speak not you?
What should I speak? I stand dishonored to have gone about to link my dear friend to a common stale.
Oh, are these things real, or do I but dream?
Sir, they are spoken, and these things are true.
This looks not like a nuptial.
True, oh God.
Leonardo, stand I here? Is this the prince? Is this the prince's sister? Is this face, heroes? Are our eyes our own?
Oh, well, yes. But what of it, my lord?
Let me move but one question to your daughter, and by that fatherly and kindly power that you have in her, bid her answer truly.
Hero, I charge you do so as you are my child.
Oh God, how am I beset? What kind of catechizing call you this?
To make you answer truly to your name.
Is it not Hero? That name with any just reproach.
Oh, Mary, that can hero. Hero itself can blot out hero's virtue. What man was he talking through at your window betwixt 12 and 1? Now, if you are a maid, answer to this.
I spoke with no man after
that. Why, then you are no maid. Leonardo, I'm sorry you must hear. Upon mine honor, myself, my sister, and this grieving count did see her. Hear her! At that hour last night, talk with a ruffian at her chamber window, who hath indeed, like a most liberal villain, confessed the vile encounters they've had a thousand times in secret.
Fie, fie, they are not to be named, my lord, not to be spoken of. There is not chastity enough in language without offense to utter them. Thus, pretty lady, I am sorry for thy much misgovernment.
Hero. What a hero hast thou been, if half thy outward graces have been placed about thy thoughts and counsels of thy heart. Farewell, most foul, most fair. Farewell thy pure impiety and impious purity. For thee I'll lock up all the gates of love, and on my eyelids shall conjecture hang to turn all thoughts of beauty into harm. Never shall it more be gracious.
Oh! Hath no man dagger here a point for me?
Oh, lady, what man is he you are accused of?
They know that do accuse me, I know none. For if I know of any man more than may modesty not warrant, let all my sins lack mercy. Father, prove you that I spoke with any man at hours unmeet, or that I conversed with any creature. Refuse me, hate me, torture me to death.
There is some strange misprision in the prince.
Two of them at the very bent of honor, and if their wisdoms be misled in this, the practice of it lives in Don the Fitch, whose spirits toil a frame of villainous.
Oh, Francis, what will become of this? What will we do?
Mary, this well-carried, shall on her behalf change slander to remorse. That is some good. She dying, as it must so be maintained, for upon the instant she was accused, shall be lamented, pitied, and excused. When he hears she died upon his words, the very image of her life shall sweetly creep into the study of his imagination, and every lovely organ of her body shall come apparelled in even more precious habit. Ooh, let this be so, and doubt not but success.
Here, Leonardo, let her you. And though you know my inwardness and love lies very much into the Prince of Claudio, yet by mine honor I will deal in this as secretly and justly as your soul should your body.
Oh, being that I flow in grief, the smallest wine may lead me.
Oh, 'tis well consented. Presently away, for to strange sores strangely they strain the cure. Come, lady, die to live. This wedding day is but prolonged. Have patience and endure.
Leonardo,
Beatrice, have you wept all this while?
Yea, and I will weep a while longer.
Well, I will not desire that.
You have no reason. I do it freely.
Surely I do believe your fair cousin is wrong.
How much might the man deserve of me that would right her?
Is there any way to show such friendship?
Even way, but no such friend.
Well, may a man do it?
It is a man's office, but not yours.
I do love nothing in the world so well as you. Is not that strange?
Strange thing I know not. It were as possible for me to say that I love nothing so much as you. But believe me not. I confess nothing. Nor deny nothing.
By my words, Beatrice, thou lovest me.
Do not swear an edict.
I will swear by that you love me, and I will make those edicts that says I love not you. No sauce that can be devised to protest I love thee.
May God forgive me.
What offense, sweet Beatrice?
I was about to protest that I love you.
Do it with all thy heart.
Love you with so much of my heart, there is none left to protest.
Come, let me do anything for thee.
Fight, Claudio.
Not for the wide world.
You fight me to deny it. Farewell.
Sweet Beatrice.
I am God! Though I'm in here. Pray you, there is no love in you. Let me go.
Beatrice.
In faith, I will go.
We'll be friends first.
You dare easier be my friend than fight my enemy?
Is Claudio thine enemy?
Is he not robed in the hide of villain? That has slandered, scorned, dishonored my kinswoman! Oh, that I were a man for his sake! God, that I were a man for his sake! I would eat his heart in the marketplace!
Hear me, Beatrice.
Go and talk with a man out a window, a proper saint!
Nay, but Beatrice...
Sweet hero! She is undone.
Beatrice.
Oh, princes and counts! A princely testimony, a princely count! Count Confect! I were a man for his sake! Or that I had any friend that would be a man for my sake. But manhood is melted in the compliment. And valor in the compliment. And men are turned into tongues. And truths too. I cannot be a man with wishing! Therefore I'll die a woman with grieving.
By this hand I love thee.
Use it for my love some other way than swearing by it.
Think you in your soul that Count Claudio has wronged hero?
Yeah, as sure as I am, I haven't thought or soul.
Enough. I am engaged. I will challenge him. I will kiss your hand. And so I leave you. By this hand, Claudio shall render me a dear account. As you hear of me, so think of me. Go, comfort your cousin. I must say that she is dead. And so farewell.
Which be the malefactors?
Mary, that am I and my partner.
Nay, that's certain, but really, we have the exhibition to examine.
But which are the offenders that are to be examined? Let them come before Master Constable.
Yea, Mary, let them come before me. What is your name, friend?
Baraccio.
Pray write down Baraccio. Yours, sirrah? I'm a thug, sir. My name is Conrad. Write down Master Thug Conrad. Masters, do you serve God?
Yea, sir, we hope.
Write down they serve God. But write God first, for God defend, but God should go before such villains. Masters, it is proved already you are a little better than false names. They will go near to be thought so shortly. How answer you for yourselves?
Mary, sir, we say we are none.
A marvelous witty fellow, I assure you. But I will go about with him. Come hither, sirrah. A word in your ear. Sir, I say to you, it is thought you are false knaves.
Sir, I say to you, we are none.
Then stand aside, for God, you are both in a tale. Have you writ down they are none?
Master Constable, you go not the way to examine. You must call forth the watch that are their accusers.
Oh, yea, that's the eftest way. Let the watch come forth. Masters, I charge you, accuse these men.
This man did say, sir, that the prince's sister Dawn was a villain.
Write down Dawn a villain. Why, this is flat perjury to call the prince's sister villain!
Master Const!
Pray thee, fellow peace, I do not like thy look, I promise thee.
What heard you him say else?
Mary, that he had received $1,000 of Dawn for accusing the lady hero wrongfully.
Flat burglary if ever was committed!
Yea, by mass, that it is.
What else, fellow?
And that Count Claudio did mean upon these words to disgrace hero before the whole assembly and not marry her.
Villain, thou will be cast into everlasting redemption for this.
What else?
This is all.
And this is more, masters, than you can deny. Dawn is this morning secretly stolen away.
Aw, damn!
Hero was in this manner accused, in this very manner refused, and upon the grief of this suddenly died. Master Constable, let these men be bound and brought to Leonardo's. $50 fine and time served.
Aw, yeah. Hate to see you leave, but I'd love to see you go, baby.
Come, let them be opinioned.
Oh, yes, of course. Let them be in the hands.
Hey, back up, jackass! God's my life, where's the sexton? Let her write down the prince's officer, jackass.
Hey, yo, 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 Han Solo here. He might dress with no class, but you, my man, you be a straight-up ass. You are an ass, bro!
Dost thou not suspect my place? Dost thou not suspect my years? Oh, that she were here to write me down an ass. Remember that I am an ass, though not be written, forget not that I am an ass. Oh, villain, thou art full of piety, as will be proved upon thee by good witness. I'm an honest man, and which is more, an officer. And which is more, a dungeon master. And which is more, as pretty a piece of flesh as any in Messina. And one that knows the law, go to. And original, go to. And one that has had bosses, and has two gowns, and everything handsome about it. Bring them away! Oh, that I had been writ down an ass!
Oh, get the gavel!
Shit.
Oh! Oh!
Good day.
Oh, good day, my lord.
We have some haste, Leonardo.
Oh, some haste. Well.
Nay, do not quarrel with this good old man.
If he could right himself with quarreling, some of us would lie low.
Who wrongs
him? Mary, thou dost wrong me, thou dissembler, thou. Nay, never lay thy hand upon my cell phone. I fear it not.
Mary, beshrew my hand if it should give your age such cause of fear. In faith, my hand meant nothing to myself.
Tush, man. Do not flare and jest at me. Do not speak to me like a daughter nor a fool. You have killed my innocent child, and I challenge thee to a trial of a man. I say that you have killed my daughter, and she lies buried in our family tomb where Scandal never slept, save this of yours framed by villainy.
My villainy?
Thine, Claudio, I say.
You say that right, old man.
Boy! I'll prove it on his body if he dare. Despite his nice fence and his active practice, his may of youth and bloom of lustihood.
Oh, away, I'll not have to deal with you.
Canst thou so daft me, boy? Thou hast killed mine child. If you kill me, you'll kill a man.
Oh, he shall kill two of us. But let him kill one first. With me and wear me. Let him answer to me. Come. Sir boy, come, follow me, boy. Come, follow me, sir boy. I'll whip you from your whining fence. Nay, as I am a woman, I will. I love my niece, and she is dead. Slandered to death by villains that dare as well answer to a man as I may take a serpent by the tongue. Boys, apes, rabbits, jacks, milksops!
Francis!
Hold your intent! What man? I know them, yea, and what they weigh, even to the utmost scruple. Scrambling out, facing fashion-monging boys that lie and cog and flout, go actively, show outward hideousness, and speak on up a dozen dangerous words, how they may hurt their enemies if they durst. And that is all.
Francis.
Oh, come. 'Tis no matter. Do not you deal in this. Let me!
We will not wait your patience. My heart is sorry for your daughter's death, but upon mine honor, she was charged with nothing but what was true and very full of proof.
Don Pedro.
I will not hear you.
No? Well, I will be heard.
And shall! Or some of us will smart for it!
Si. Here comes the man we went to see.
Senor, what news?
Good day, my lord.
Welcome, senor.
You're almost a compart, almost afraid.
We just about got our two noses snapped right off by these old geezers without teeth.
Leonardo and his sister, what thinkest thou? Had we fought, I doubt we should have been too young for them.
In a false world, there is no true valor. I came to seek you both. You are a villain.
Oh, I just not!
I will make it good how you dare, with what you dare, and when you dare. Do me right, or I will protest your cowardice. You have killed a sweet lady. Death shall fall heavy on you. Fare you well, boy. You know my mind. I'll leave you now to your gossip-like humor. You break jest as braggarts do their blades, which, God be thanked, hurt not. My lord, for your many courtesies, I thank you. I must discontinue your company. Your sister, the bitch, is fled from Messina. Uh-huh. You have among you killed a sweet and innocent lady. For my lord Blackbeard there, he and I shall meet. Until then, peace be with him.
He is in earnest. Most profound earnest. And I'll warrant you for the love of Beatrice.
And hath challenged thee.
Most sincerely.
What a pretty thing man is when he goes out in his hose and doublet and leaves off his wit.
He is then a giant to an ape, but then is an ape a doctor to such a man.
But did he not say my sister was fled?
sir, if justice cannot chain you, then she shall ne'er weigh more reasons in her balance. Nay, to be proved a cursing hypocrite once, you must be looked to.
What has Borachio done now?
Mary, sir, he has committed false report. Moreover, he has spoken untruths. Secondarily, he is a slanderer. Sixth and lastly, he has belied a lady. Thirdly, he has verified unjust things. And to conclude, he's a lying knave.
First, I ask thee what he has done. Thirdly, I ask you what his offense. Sixth and lastly, I ask you why he is committed. And to conclude, what you lay to his charge?
A rightly reasoned and in his own division. And in faith, there is one meaning well suited.
Borachio, what have you done that you have thus bound to your answer? This learned constable is too cunning to be understood. What is your offense?
Sweet prince, go no farther than mine answer. Do you hear me? Let this count kill me, for I have deceived even your very eyes. Which your wisdoms could not discover, shallow fools have brought to light, who in the dark night overheard me confessing to my boy how your sister incensed me to slander the lady hero. How you two were brought into the orchard to see this. How you disgraced her when you should have married her. My villainy, these fools have upon record, which I'd rather see with my death than repeat over my shame. In brief, I desire nothing but the reward of a villain.
Is not this speech like iron through your blood?
Oh, I have drunk poison while he uttered it.
But did my sister set thee on to this?
Yea, and paid me richly for the practice.
She is composed and framed of treachery, and fled she is upon his villainy.
Oh, sweet hero. Now thy image doth appear in the rare semblance I loved at first.
Come, bring away this plaintiff. By now our sexton has reformed Signora Leonardo of the map. Masters, I beseech you, when the time and place shall serve, do not forget to specify that I am an ass.
Here comes Master Signor Leonardo.
Where is he? Where is the villain?
You would know your wrong. Look on me.
Art thou the slave that with thy breath has killed my innocent child?
Yea, even I alone.
Oh, don't flatter yourself. Here stand a pair of honorable young men. A third is fled that had a hand in it. I thank you, princes, for my daughter's death. It was bravely done. Record it with your high and worthy deeds if you bethink you of it.
I know not how to pray your patience, yet I must speak. Choose your revenge yourself. Impose on me what penance your invention can lay upon my sin, yet sinned I not but in mistaking.
By my soul, nor I. And yet, to satisfy this good old man, I would gladly bend under any heavy weight that will enjoin me to.
Oh, I cannot bid you bid my daughter live. That were impossible! But, possess the people in Messina here how innocent she died, and... Claudio, if you love her as much as you claim to, then go to her tomb tonight and sing to her bones. Tomorrow morning, return to me. My sister hath a child that is almost the copy of mine own. Give her the right you should have given mine, and my vengeance dies with her.
Oh, noble sir, your overkindness doth wring tears for me. I do embrace your charge and dispose henceforth of poor Claudio.
Very well. Tomorrow I will look for your coming. As for tonight, this naughty man will be brought with me to have words with Margaret, whom I believe was in some fault in all this.
No, she was not. She knew not what she did when she spoke to me. She's always been just and virtuous in anything I know by her.
You are a bad, ill-mannered little youth.
Moreover, sir, which indeed is not in black and white, plaintiff here, the offender, he'd call me ass. I beseech you remember it in his punishment.
How now, son? Here. Here is for thy care and honest pains.
A magic card. Your worship speaks like most kind and reverend youth.
Here is for thy care and honest pains.
Two magic cards. God save the foundation.
Here. Three magic cards. Now, will you take your magic cards and your little light pokey things and all that stuff? Will you just go?
I leave an errant knave with your worship.
that your worship may correct for the example of others.
Okay.
God keep your worship. God restore you to health. I bid your worship good tidings. And if a merry meeting may be wished, God prohibit it. I humbly bid you leave to depart. Come, apprentice.
Magic term!
I'll look for you tomorrow, my lords. Come here, little turd.
Tonight on Morn of Hero. Margaret, help me do the speech of Beatrice.
I will call Beatrice to you, who I think hath legs.
And therefore will come. Lady Beatrice. Thou come when I called thee?
Yes, senor, and depart when you bid me.
I'll stay but till then.
Oh, that is spoken very well. But before I go, let me go with that which I came, which is to know what hath passed between you and Claudio.
Only foul words. And thereupon I will kiss her.
Foul words is but foul wind, and foul wind is but foul breath, and foul breath is noisome. Therefore I will depart unkissed.
I must tell thee plainly. Claudio undergoes my challenge, and I either must shortly hear from him, or I will subscribe him a coward. And I pray thee now, for which of my bad parts did thou first fall in love with me?
For all of them together, which maintains so politic a state of evil that would not allow any good parts to intermingle with them. But for which of my bad parts did you first suffer love for me?
Suffer love? A good epithet, for I do suffer love indeed, for I love thee against my will.
In spite of your heart, methinks. Alas, poor heart. You do spite it for my sake, and I'll spite it for yours. For I can never love that which my friend hates.
Thou and I are too wise to move me.
Madam, you must come to your uncle! Yonder's old quote of home, it is proved, my lady Hero hath been wrongly accused. The prince and Claudio mightily abused, and Donna D'Otherval, who is fled and gone. Will you come presently?
Will you come hear this news with me, senor?
I will live in thy heart, die in thy lap, and be buried in thy eyes. Moreover, I will go with thee to thy uncle's. Is this the monument of Leonato? Done to death with slanderous tongues was the hero that here lies. Death, in reward of her wrongs, gives her fame which never dies. So the life that died with shame lives in death with glorious fame. Hang thou there upon the tomb, praising her when I am dumb. Now, music, sound and sing thy solemn hymn.
Sorry, we broke up.
to thy bones. Good night. Yearly will I do this right.
The wolves have prayed and looked a gentle day. Roundabout dapples the drowsy east with spots of gray. Thanks to you all and leave us.
Yes.
Fare you well.
Each his own way.
Come, let us hence and put on other weeds, and then to lean out we will go.
So you did, and so are the Prince and Claudio, who we debated upon. But I think that little Miss Margaret was in some fault in all this.
Well, I'm just glad that all things sort so well.
And so am I. Being else by fate and forced to call young Claudio to a reckoning for it.
Ladies, you know your duty. Withdraw into the other room, and when my sister comes, come get her mask. Now, sister, you must be mother to your brother's daughter and give her to Count Claudio when he asks.
Which I will do with confirmed countenance.
Francis, I must entreat your pain.
To do what, senor?
To bind me, or undo me. One of them. Senor Leonardo, truth it is, good senor, your niece regards me with an eye of favor.
Oh, that I, my daughter, lent her, 'tis most true.
And I do with an eye of love. Requite her?
Well, that eye you got from me, the prince and Claudio, but what's your will, son?
Your answer, sir, is enigmatical. But for my will is your good will. You may stand with ours this day to be conjoined in a state of honorable marriage, in which, good friar, I shall desire your help.
My heart is with you then, son.
And my help. Oh, here come the Count Claudio.
Good morrow to this fair assembly.
Good morrow, lords. Claudio, me and you to keep your word this day.
Yes, I will hold my mind.
Sister, I think we're ready.
Good morrow, Benedict. Why, what's the matter that you have such a February face, so full of frost, of storm, and cloudiness?
Oh, I think he thinks upon the savage bull. Oh, fear not, man. We'll tip thy horns with gold, and all Europa shall rejoice at thee, as once Europa did at lusty Jove, when he would play the noble beast in love.
Well, Jove, sir, had an amiable low, and some such strange bull leaped your father's cow and got a calf in the same noble feet, much like to you, if you have just as bleached.
Oh, I will owe thee an answer for that one, but here comes other reckonings. Which is the lady I must seize upon?
The same is she, and I do give you her.
Sweet, let me see your face.
Now, not until you take her hand and swear before this friar to marry her.
Before this holy friar, I am your husband, if you like of me.
When I lived, I was your other wife. And when you love, you are my other husband.
Another hero!
One hero died defiled, but I do live. And surely as I live, I am a maid.
The former hero? The hero that is dead?
Oh, Joke. She died, my lord. But while her slanders lived.
Oh, all this amazement can I qualify. When after that the holy rites are ended, I shall tell you largely of fair hero's death. Meantime, let wonder seem familiar, and to the chapel let us presently.
Something, fair Francis. Which is Beatrice?
I answered to that name. What is your will?
Do not you love me?
Why, no! No more than in reason.
Why, then, your uncle and the prince and Claudio have been deceived. They swore that you did. Truth, no.
Bullshit!
Why then, my cousin Ursula and Margaret are very much deceived, for they did swear you did.
They swore you were almost sick for me.
Well, they swore you were well nigh dead for me.
'Tis no such matter. You do not love me?
No, no more than in a friendly recompense.
Oh, now, cousin, I'm sure you love the man.
And I will swear upon it that he loves her, for here's a paper written in his own hand, a homesick sonnet back to Beatrice.
And here's another written by my cousin here professing her affections unto Saturday.
Thou wilt be if my cousin doth exceeding merrily. Come, come, we are friends. Let us be married and drawn to a close. Prince, thou art sad. Get thee a wife. Get thee a wife.
Thank you.